Yeah, I don't know where that is, y'all, but ain't you ever been where you ain't had no problem nowhere? Come on, somebody. When you get in the midst of Jesus, Jesus gives you that comfort that it may be some stuff going on, but it can't mess with you. That's why you have the peace that only God can provide for you. And so here it is. We got to focus, y'all, on drawing. In John, the 6th chapter, we got some folk that has traveled. Come on, somebody. They had followed Jesus to Capernaum. Messing around there, and they had heard about Jesus. But they also had heard about how he had failed. Y'all don't hear me? Those people with those fish. Huh? Come on, somebody. They heard, and so what happened as he went to ministry, folk were being drawn. They were coming. They were coming out of the woodwork. But folk were coming not because of the Savior, but they were coming because of the bread. Y'all don't hear me in here. They were being drawn because of the benefits Jesus was offering. Jesus knew that in order for them to make it through storms, in order for them to make it through trials, you got to have more than this physical stuff. In order for you to hang in there and fight the demons off and be able to fight those depressions and the oppressors off, you got to have more than just physical food. You got to have the bread of life that comes from heaven. A lot of us, we eating the wrong stuff. Right. We eating a whole lot of gossip and opinions. Yeah. Wish I had some help in here. Right. We listen to a lot of advertisements on the TV. Right. I wish I had some help in here. Right. We done read a lot of stuff on labels. Yeah. Come on, somebody. But I think you need to get into the Word. Yeah. Can I get some help? That's where the real bread is. You need to study the Word. To show thyself approved, huh? So you'll be a workman that need not to be a what? Shame. Because the devil will make you ashamed if you're not fed the bread of life. Traditions won't make it, y'all. Customs won't fit it. But you got to know what the Word of God has to say. Because it is the bread of life. Jesus says something here. Oh, glory be here to his name. In verse 44, I just picked it out because it stuck out. It said, no man can come to me. Huh? Except the Father, which has sent me, draw him. Now notice the. Oh, what can I say? Notice the humility that Jesus exemplifies. Here he was, born in an immaculate conception, had blessings coming all out of him, but yet he humbles himself and says, the folk are coming. But notice that he doesn't get lifted up. He doesn't get high-minded because he realizes it's not me that's doing the drawing. But this verse says, no man coming to me except the Father which has what? Sent me, draw him. It is not me, but it's my Father which is in heaven doing the drawing. And notice, they can't come to Jesus until God sends them. God, he prepares folk to go to Jesus. You want to know why you're going through this stuff? You don't want to know why you're going through your trials? You want to know why you're going through your ups and downs? You're getting ready to see Jesus. You're getting ready to meet Jesus. Can I get some help in here? Look what happened to the woman that was bleeding for 12 years. It took her 12 years to get ready. Y'all don't hear me in here. God She tried everything she knew. I wish I had some help in here. She went to every doctor she thought she knew. Tried every trick in the book. And you know, we got some tricksters in the church. They'll try anything. Yeah, I wish I had. To bypass Jesus. But Jesus says, no man. Woo! Huh? Coming to me unless the Father sends him. We got to understand what that word is, that drawing. Because God has an, yes, he has an irresistible drawing. Sometimes you can't help yourself. You find yourself doing what God said and you don't even know why. Paul said, why did I find myself doing stuff that I said I wasn't going to do? Amen. Is that irresistible drawing? Why I find myself loving folk that I know hate me? Because it's the irresistible drawing. Why do I give when I feel like I ain't got nothing else to give no more? It's the irresistible drawing. It's that power that only God can exhibit. Check out what's going on here. We got to understand these words have often been supposed to mean that no one can become a Christian unless an irresistible influence is put forth by God for his conversion. But if you look at the words of the text in their connection and relation to the circumstances that has already been written, you will see that Jesus is not here speaking either of eternal goings or anything that might be of the eternal life. But what has drawn these crowds across the lake, number one, away from their homes, away from their jobs, is they cared merely for material benefits. Huh? Which Christ's miracles had conferred. They left their homes. They left their jobs because of the fish. Y'all don't hear me in here. They came across the lake because of material benefits. They had eaten of the loaves and they were filled. They were not following the drawing of the Father. They were merely drawn by the loaves